Good Idea Productions, and welcome to our first attempt at what we're going to call a podcast. I don't really know how it's going to turn out, but today we have the five of us here. That is me, I'm Gil, or Nxai, whatever you want to call me. I don't really care. We have Bromad the Nomad, we have Dankill, we have Sora9567, and we have Werewolf with us today.
Shit!
We are going to start, tentatively, you know, hoping nobody screws this up.
Yeah, really.
With an overview of E3. So let's go with Bromad the Nomad to start us off. Where do you want to go from here?
I think we should discuss how Bethesda won E3.
Quite.
I would.
Do I sound presumptuous enough?
I'm just going to say Yarny, though. All I've got to say.
I don't like the idea that someone wins E3. It's about entertainment, and it's about, you know, just playing games. I don't think that we need to make this a fucking competition, especially since we all know that
it wasn't a competition. But if it was, they clearly won.
The problem with it is, in some ways, it is a competition because you have several competitors putting forth their new IPs and/or their, you know, next product line, and they're all putting that forth, and then, you know, people are comparing them against each other and deciding who they're going to go with. So in a way, it is a competition by default.
All right, yeah. Buzz. I just want to say this. Just Cause 3.
Just Cause 3.
Yes.
I'm excited.
Oh,
I'm
boy.
Excited.
Pretty
oh, boy.
Sweet stuff. I mean, I've only played, like, two of the Just Cause games. I think there's only two, considering that...
There's only two.
Yeah.
I only
That's why they're making
very
a third.
Briefly, so I don't really understand how to play them. I'm bad with the controls, and my computer runs horribly, so Just
the
Cause 2 doesn't really run very well. All I'm saying is that just linking those helicopters and stuff together with the ripcord thing.
Oh, that was the best.
Oh, Gil, have you not partaken in Just Cause 2 multiplayer?
Like I said, my computer is horrible. Playing that with you guys a couple of times.
Honestly, that shows you like the quality of the game, where when it's strictly a single player with absolutely no online capabilities whatsoever, they decide to, well, modders at least, they decide to make it into a freaking multiplayer game. It's fantastic.
Oh. If only there were more things to shoot in said multiplayer game besides other
yeah,
players.
Yeah, really.
Then yeah. We'd have a full experience.
They kind of took away Definitely. The enemies for the most part.
Well, that's because random nerds is the most dangerous thing you can have in an online game.
That, and I'm
it's
sure that there are
the
technical limitations
game.
And stuff, because what, the server's gonna hold like a thousand players?
All running different instances
yeah.
of areas.
Wasn't it just a mod at first?
Well, no, now it's like an actual like thing that you download through Steam and everything else.
It's a bigger mod.
Effectively.
It's a special
it's
mod.
It's a mod with its own download.
It's an advanced mod.
No, it's paid mods.
That's all
it is. Okay,
if we're
gonna
talk about things that are the same thing but advanced, though, the Final Fantasy VII remake, the same thing but advanced.
I am going to be extremely tentative about that because on one hand, they could just do what they did with the Final Fantasy IV remake. And just, like, update the sprites or character models and fix translation errors. But this is Square Enix we're talking about, not Squaresoft. Square Enix.
Oh,
I have very little faith.
Squaresoft.
They
Rest
made Super Mario
Squaresoft.
RPG.
Super Mario RPG.
Rest in peace, yes. But I have very little faith in this. Because I feel like every attempt at a new Final Fantasy game in the last, god, like, 10 years... has just been a fucking cash grab for them. They've really stopped caring, and I'm also in the minority of people who doesn't like Final Fantasy VII from the beginning.
I'm just in the ultimate minority.
In the original game, like Cloud, at least had some personality. Like, sure, he moped and moaned all the time, but at least sometimes he cracked wise.
I feel like I should just go make a bowl of ramen right now because I have never played a Final Fantasy game.
Stay focused. Stay on target.
You know, I'm playing Final Fantasy currently, and
which one?
Seven. Yeah, the one we're fucking talking right. about. What?
How about that?
What would you know about? Yeah. I don't really know how far I am into it. I know that I just got off the boat, and I'm basically at some sort of resort town kicking a ball back and forth with some kids. That's the
West
important
part. West
of
Del Sol, I think.
Yeah. Del Sol something. But so far, I'm really, like, I know the whole story of the game, but I'm really not seeing Cloud's importance to the whole thing. He just sort of seems there.
Exactly.
The plot gets weird real
the plot,
like, at some point.
The plot was, it started out understandable enough. Hey, you work for these guys. You don't really care. Where's my paycheck? And then it got Sephiroth, don't you remember me? And I'm just like, where did...
And then it got all...
Cloud could have easily just said no, and the story would have ended right there.
Credits.
Yeah, really.
It really would have been done.
But yeah, it's just like... with
no, the story would have ended with a single line of, when do I get my paycheck?
Yeah.
Yep. But Chandler?
But, like, this is, like, Square Enix, and they don't really show a lot of restraint in terms of over-the-topness.
That can be a good thing.
Yeah.
It can be a good thing, like, see, again, Just Cause 2 or Metal Gear Rising Revengeance, but they, with Square Enix, they just have a bunch of crap on screen with people, like, jumping and flying everywhere, and it's just like, there's no substance.
Yeah, that's why a lot of people are saying, yeah, that's why
trouble.
A lot of people are saying that the reason that, you know, Bethesda kicked ass in E3 is because of all of the game footage they showed. They've showed virtually no, like, cinematic. They mostly showed game footage.
And that's the thing, like, certain games, like action, adventure games, they should rely more on gameplay, whereas with, like, more story-focused games like The Walking Dead by Telltale Games and other things like that, more emphasis should be on the story.
Yeah.
However, correct. There are some games that can do both well, like, see, Wolfenstein The New Order.
Well, wasn't Wolfenstein The New Order, didn't all of their cinematics just render in the game engine?
Yeah. Yes, and it was very seamless, yeah. And it worked really well.
Exactly.
It's beautiful. I'm playing through it now,
really,
and I'm
and also, for, alright, we need to talk about this. Like, in terms of who the protagonist for the newest Doom should be, like, should it either be, like, pretty much BJ Blazkowicz except in space, or should the Doom guy be the protagonist equivalent of Senator Armstrong?
Well, here's a question. Is this part of the Doom canon, or is this a remake like Doom 3 was?
I don't know. At this point, I don't think it really matters.
Doom 1 and 2
had a canon. We know the story. Demons in Hell, shoot them in the face.
Yeah, because 2 was a direct sequel to 1, because what happened was... wasn't it? Yeah, they were on Mars in the first game, and then they opened up a portal to Hell on Earth in the second game, and
hence
that's
the
basically what's happening.
Doom 2,
yeah,
Hell
here's
on
a question:
Earth.
If there's a Hell yeah. on Earth and they were on Mars, does that mean there's a Hell on Mars too?
There's
yes,
a Mars
actually,
Hell.
That's precisely what it means.
Interesting.
What's,
that was the plot of
what's
there was
the
a Mars,
difference between
there was a
Mars
Earth Hell?
Hell
this
and
isn't
Mars
just
hell.
Your regular. This isn't your regular
well, they opened
everyday
portals
hell.
To
this
hell.
Is advanced
it's
hell.
Sci-fi hell.
It was a portal to hell. It wasn't actually, like... They didn't take hell and push it somewhere else. It was a portal to hell.
Quite. I just imagine that every planet has a hell, and when you awaken it, that's when you're fucked.
Well, Doom 2
know, like...
ended with Doom guy basically staying in hell going, alright, they're gonna have to go through me.
Well, apparently they went through him. In waves.
Maybe you'll find his body.
Well, no, Doom 2 ended that way, and then we
or
got Doom 3, which was a remake.
Well, if
Doom
4
yeah, Doom 3
keeps
was
the canon,
one.
They went through him in waves.
Well, no, judging from the, like, the teaser thing, like I think a year ago, it was just basically the UAC going, hey, you know that crap that totally annihilated us the first time? Let's try that again. Well,
so this might be a remake
here's
of 2.
What we can,
maybe.
Here's what we should go on. Okay, Doom 4, the new Doom. They showed that thing where you can make the levels yourself.
Oh, that's
that was
fucking
really
great.
Cool. Yeah.
Love Live.
You're literally going to take up more time than
go
that.
Well, you could do between, that before.
They said that they could go on consoles with that, too. That would transfer between PC and consoles, I believe.
No. That's talking about the Fallout 4 mods that are going to be transferable between PC and console.
I'm pretty sure the map said.
The maps thing.
We can move on.
Let me look it up right now.
The maps thing is literally just going to be a part of the game. It's going to be like Forge for Halo. Oh, wait, no. Damn it. You guys are all fucking PlayStation.
I remember Forge.
Discuss article.
I had a lot of fun with
it. It's going to be a lot.
I also had fun
It's going to be
Forge.
A lot like Forge for Halo. It's just going to be built into the game. It's not going to require mods or anything. Mods are going to be the thing that's going to be transferable between PC and Xbox for the Halo 4 now.
I remember hearing someone say that if you built a map, you can download it on whatever it is you're on.
I also remember this.
I'm not seeing anything on the IGN article that I found, but
that's going to be more than likely just an account thing. Like, again, in the Halo series, I swear to God, I'm going to have to use these references because it's the only thing I have to run on. In the series, you could make the maps, and then Bungie had a, highlight list of the coolest maps in their opinion that they put up, and then you could then go and download those maps that somebody else made onto your device. And they had an account thing where you could also go onto your PC, find somebody's account, and then set it to download their map onto your game. So I imagine it's going to be like that, but maybe cross-platform.
What they had done in the original Doom was it was literally just WAD files that you could, because they were really small. A lot of people were writing up Doom maps, and it was just one file that you would send out. I'm imagining it's going to be a lot more complex now.
Yeah, it's like
but
bigger.
they have experience with this kind of thing.
Yeah.
So it shouldn't be a problem.
Indeed.
Yeah, and I can at least hold out for the gameplay is good, because it looks to me like it'll kind of follow with Wolfenstein Order with very visceral gunplay. And from what I can tell, the shotgun looks good.
As long as the
sounds good. That's the most important
shotguns
thing.
Shotguns have to have a good feel, because that's a major
and
problem that I had with Doom 3 is the shotgun didn't really feel like it gave a lot of impact.
I'm going to be honest, guns either make or break for me in a lot of games just because of the sound they make.
If there's not a good enough bang, why am I using this? I need heavier bullets.
Daka.
There's a reason I have a problem
with
a lot
shotguns
of Call of
in Wolfenstein Order. They felt like you were dual wielding AA-12s, and that's what you were doing.
Yes.
Yeah, no, and in the Call of Duty series, that's one of my main problems, is a lot of the guns don't sound like guns. They sound like pew-pew machines.
Well, there was actually a comparison between the sounds of Call of Duty and Battlefield. The Battlefield sounds sounded much better, that's because they were actually realistic sounds.
All I remember is that the MP7 felt like a laser gun.
Yep. The MP7 was Babby's first rapid fire.
And in Modern Warfare 2, the FAMAS was the best gun in the game.
Quite.
Well, when isn't the FAMAS the best gun in a Call of Duty game?
Every game besides Modern Warfare 2, Gil. Literally.
I don't know about that. I've seen some nerds playing with the FAMAS that just sort of go pew 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 pew, and everyone goes
honestly,
away.
Honestly, I stopped with Call of Duty after Black Ops 2 because it wasn't really a point, because then I would have to buy a new Call of Duty every year because they were oversaturating it, and the second a new Call of Duty game came out, all the people on previous games jumped ship, so I had no one to play with, and that made me as a 13-year-old.
Let's not segue into a game that none of us like, when we can segue back into Bethesda content and talk about Fallout 4.
They have jet
caps. System.
The bottle caps, did you guys hear about
sent
that?
Sent a bunch of bottle caps to Bethesda, and they actually accepted
sent
it.
Sent 11
they allowed
pounds
it.
Of bottle caps, I believe.
2,000 bottle caps, and they said it counted as a pre-order.
They're giving him the actual game.
I really hope they give him the Pip-Boy edition. I do.
They didn't say anything about that. I've got it right here. Here's the, there's his letter. A Twitter post by someone from Bethesda. Yes, my office smells like beer. It's just boxes full of caps. It's all it says is he's going to receive a copy of the game. It doesn't say anything about the Pip-Boy edition.
I have something to bring up about the gameplay, specifically in terms of dialogue. Like, because in the trailer it showed, like, I guess Troy Baker saying something, I guess that got a lot of people hopped over something. In terms of gameplay, like, which would you guys rather see? Like, the sort of, like, idea of, like, you select a phrase a la Mass Effect or Dragon Age and the character says something, or would you prefer it to be in traditional Fallout sense where there isn't any voice dialogue, it would just give you the options and the exact words and you can pick from that? I personally would like the latter.
I'm not sure. If they make it work, I think the real thing is not what they do per se, it's if they make whatever they choose to do.
Exactly. Todd Howard got interviewed by, I think it was GameSpot or IGN, about why they chose to do it, and he said something along the lines of, he said he wanted to actually, like, control, like, the dialogue a bit more to, you know, for the storytelling purposes, because that way he could, like, control the pacing of it and everything else.
Well, personally, I'm hoping, like, it'll actually be like Dragon Age Origins, where your in-game character does have a voice, and it'll say, like, things like when you're fighting or whatever, but it'll give you the dialogue choices where, like, there's nothing being said, and you can just pick the options, so that way less money will go into voice actings and more money will go into, like, the writing and story and blah, 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 blah.
Here's my opinion.
Yo.
How I feel about it is that they did the same thing that they did with Gordon Freeman in Half-Life, and you get that real Avatar sense because your character doesn't speak, you pick their speech and they don't have a voice, so it's like they don't do anything that you're not thinking. My concern, because we saw in the trailer that the player has voice recordings.
Troy Baker.
I don't think they're gonna do like they did in Fallout 3 in New Vegas. I think that everything's gonna be like Mass Effect and have recordings. But I feel like you're gonna lose some of the depth. You're gonna lose, like, you know, that the real Avatar sense that you got out of it because your character's actually.
It's gonna
speaking.
Be really hard for modders, I think, to actually, like, create that content.
That could be a point.
Yeah, that's what I was also thinking as well.
But from the
footage
that they showed, I mean, really.
Don't remind me of that, Tony.
From the footage that they showed, I would say that even if it's just going the everything is content that we've already decided what you're saying, you just have to pick whether you're going Renegade or whatever the other thing was in this context. Just from what they showed at E3, I'd say that the dialogue they've got is pretty good. I mean, like, the robot shows up 200 years later and asks if you want some food. That's pretty 10 out of 10.
Well, regardless...
Bethesda's always had great comedic time.
Well, regardless of, like, what the choice is going to be, I just want a good game.
True. I'm mostly excited about the crafting system and, oh god, the guns.
That looks
the
good.
Guns.
And Fallout The Sims?
Yeah.
Yes. I'm ready for Fallout The Sims. Ignore that, by the way.
I'm very ready for it, too.
Yeah, no, I can't even...
Although,
begin.
Unfortunately, I'm not going to pre-order it.
I'm
not going to either.
If I can preload it, I'll pre-order it.
I pre-ordered it for the Pip-Boy edition, mostly. I told you guys I managed to get my hands on that. Those went too fast. Oh my god. Those went
so
fast.
Yeah, and the scalpers are...
The scalpers are...
The scalpers are strong.
The scalpers
with
have
that.
So many of them.
And
oh,
resellers.
Assholes.
They're all scalpers.
Yeah, resellers are our scalpers, didn't, Christian.
Didn't the first wave of those sell out in like half an hour?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The hype was real,
the PC
man.
Copies were gone within 10 minutes.
That Jesus. Is absolutely ridiculous. That is the hype train on some, like, nuclear fuel. Going, this is the hype train just crashed, and this is why Fallout 4 happened, because
well, I mean,
the hype train just fucking crashed.
You heard about what happened.
Got the hype train
you
exploded.
Heard what happened with,
and hype train created a
you
new.
You heard about what happened with Fallout Shelter.
And left some.
I did.
Fallout.
Everyone was so hyped that they're actually making it for Android now.
Well, no, Fallout Shelter, literally, nice. It became so popular in this short of a period of time, it dethroned Candy Crush on the App Store.
Immediately.
Oh, oh my goodness.
Immediately dethroned Candy Crush.
Fantastic.
We have toppled the
behemoth. Let's get a round of applause for that.
I think Clash of Clans and Game of War are still up above it, are still up on it in the iOS store, but I'm pretty sure once it comes out for Android, all the apps are just going to be like, why?
And watch, it's going to follow the same route as Adventure Capitalist and be released on Steam. Yep. And then I'll have a time sink to do forever.
Oh, God.
Or just something to play while I'm waiting for GT Online to load.
Right.
Yeah, because that takes forever.
Yeah, but...
Oh, I'm going to get my hands on GTA 5.
So...
You should.
Join our crew.
So, it's fun.
What do you guys think about the difference, though, in geographical spectrum from 3 to 4?
I mean, it takes
it's
place
gonna
in
feel
Boston.
The same as
the,
from
the
3 to New
Vegas. The reason I
think
it's going to be interesting is because it's set in the exact same time frame as 3 was set in. It's set in 2077, literally on.
I wonder if we're going to hear about the Pyramid.
I am curious about that. I want to see us hearing about stuff that happened in the other game. I almost want them to kind of go the Mass Effect route, where your decisions in a previous save can affect your decisions in Fallout 4. Like, if you decided not
that
to...
That would be
kinda
so...
Like with Project Purity.
Yeah, if you decided not to fuck the mutants in Fallout 3, then you can hear about, good things happening in Fallout 4, you know?
Yeah. Oh, also, this is actually a very good point. So, I think, if I remember correctly, in an interview after Fallout 4 was made, I don't have a link, unfortunately, but they were talking about how they might have to redo the series or something because they expressed that in Fallout New Vegas that things were kind of getting too civilized and stuff, because you had, really major groups such as the NCR, which is just basically civilizing things.
Exactly.
Whereas in Fallout 3 and I suppose 4... that was in the area where they were hit the hardest in terms of nuclear fallout and such. So I think with Fallout 4, it's going to have more of a Fallout 3-y feel, where it's just things are a lot less organized.
But then again...
With Fallout New Vegas, where basically they had an entire city that wasn't even affected by the fallout.
Yeah, because I think it was
yes.
Mr.
So of course,
kind
of course
affected.
Things are still going to be sort of civilized. I mean, you don't have the blast actually going off there. You've got some nuclear fallout, sure, that, wafted down.
An important thing to mention, Gil, is that in New Vegas, in the ruins of Las Vegas, there were tribes and stuff who scalped people for... to quote Benny's right-hand man, just for fun.
Whoa.
So things weren't civilized just because nukes weren't hit there. It's just that without civilization, people kind of went native.
Yeah. It was something more with Mr. House protecting the actual Vegas Strip and the resounding area, because there were areas that were, extremely affected by Fallout. Really far to the south, you had that one town that you walked into, and it was 40 rads a second.
Oh, that's because Legion detonated a dirty bomb there, but let's get back on track to Fallout 4.
Yeah, no.
So how do you guys feel about the change in color?
I love it. Oh,
overall.
I love it.
Well, honestly, it's good that it actually has some color to it.
Rainbow.
I like color.
Whereas
the
you have
colors?
With Fallout 3, where everything has a nasty green tinge, and with New Vegas...
Orange.
New Vegas.
It was just orange.
Orange.
Give me the rainbow. I need the rainbow.
Yes.
Taste the rainbow.
Yeah, it's important to have, the color.
I wonder if they just took a rainbow and threw, a picture of a rainbow, and threw a dart at it, and wherever it landed, that was the primary color in their palette.
I wonder if we're... Why not? Well, I think with Fallout 3, it's green because just, they want to, incorporate this sickly green CRT color. They have a feeling of retro future.
Which, I mean, it is still retro future. I think that Fallout 4 is going to go a little bit New Vegas's route with the, city building and building the towns and stuff. It's more rebuilding than coming into a society that's already that's already kind of rebuilt now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what are you guys going to name your town?
I'm not sure. Burger Town.
Fort Kickass.
Fort Kickass. Yeah, yeah. Kickassia.
You know there's going to be someone who's going to, like, perfectly rebuild Megaton.
You know
Megaton.
What? Let's not go there.
With
please.
A nuke right in the middle that can just be detonated on a whim.
Let's not get into the people that are going to put too many hours in. There, I mean, there's a difference between putting in the required couple hundred hours in a good game and then the people that go in and they recreate other games inside of games.
Animal Crossing, who said
that? It's the difference between us playing Minecraft and people who build, like, recreations of all of the Lord of the Rings in Minecraft.
The entire Skyrim.
Yeah,
yeah, unfortunately, I'm not going to be pre-ordering, like, Fallout 4, because if you see Arkham Knight,
yeah, you aren't,
even if it's a fantastic game, it might just be butchered.
Well, that was because
you
Arkham Knight was
happy
meant
about
to be on
pre-orders
console
in the first place.
Well, here's the thing. So was Middle-Earth Shadow of Mordor, and that game was pretty well optimized for PC.
Well, no,
I
exactly. It's how much effort the company is going to put into making a PC port or actually making the game for PC. And Bethesda's always been keen to making their games for PC, not just making a PC port. Like, on the Bethesda Twitter page, they've already kind of shots fired at Xbox, saying that on Xbox and PS4, it's going to be limited to 1080p and 30fps, where on PC it's unlimited, and so, you know, people are like, oh man, they don't like Xbox, blah blah blah.
Well, that's because PC has more freedom.
Works.
You can put more RAM, put better
if you
stuff
want
in
to
there.
Talk about shots actually getting fired. Let's talk about, what was it, the Destiny Red Bull promotion
and
Dying Light putting out,
send us
a picture
so
of
you
drinking
about
a cup of water.
Oh man,
because they're just
great.
Like, Red Bull is trash, drink water instead and we'll give you some in-game stuff.
Precisely.
That.
Well, to be fair, Red Bull is not good.
It's not
that
good
was
for
shots
you.
Fired. Real. That was the proverbial nuke right there.
But here's what I'd like to bring to the table. Because we're talking about, like, you were just ranting on about PC. Who agrees with me that consoles are kind of dead after this generation? I mean, Nintendo's got the NX coming out because they think that the Wii U is a failure. But
well, to be fair, they don't release any freaking games for the thing.
I think that, okay,
they need more IPs.
They
really
do.
That's Nintendo's problem.
That's Nintendo's biggest problem. They need a lot more IPs, and the thing is, they're not, they dropped the ball entirely at E3. They didn't put out anything that was worthwhile.
Okay, the only
Star Fox, but we're drifting from the topic. Consoles dying in general.
I think that they are, basically.
I think they will always have a place, like with handhelds.
Yeah,
I think consoles are in a certain predicament. They're sort of a niche type thing right now. Because back during the PS2 generation, that was when consoles were at their peak. You know, PS2 and Xbox was great. But game development has actually changed in the last years since then. Back then, you know, you were still coming off of all of the classic arcade stuff from PS1 and the NES and the GameCube and all of that into the PS2 generation, where they had more power with the same creativity.
Yeah.
And now it's really become more of a standardized thing. It's less about making, you know, just a creative game and more about making a sequel to a game that's already done well. It's more about the
and
next
also,
Call of Duty.
And also with
out.
The most recent generation, they're focusing on the graphics and major set pieces instead of the gameplay itself.
That's a lot of things.
Yep. It's just kind of rolling with and going with tradition. It's just what's being expected
of the
market.
I think the difference in the problem with it is, though, I think consoles are going to stick around because you still have Microsoft and you still have Sony, and they're still dishing out dishing out large portions of cash to developers to make their games exclusive. For instance, you know, From Software with Bloodborne, like, more, I doubt that it would have been a PS4 exclusive if Sony hadn't, you know, given them a little bit of help. Same reason that Bethesda's putting Fallout 4 mods on Xbox One before they're putting them on PS4. It's because Xbox is just somebody who they either have a history with or vice versa. I think the problem is, though, that because of exclusives and games like that, we're going to still have consoles. But as far as hardware goes, consoles are starting to fall behind because they can't pack strong enough hardware into the consoles to rival the PC market without without making it affordable to consumers. For instance, Xbox, when they dropped the price of the Xbox One down to $350, they started losing money. And that's basically what they're doing. So they're losing money right now on their sales, but they're trying to get money back on their sales because they have this thing that they've created. And so now they're kind of stuck with it.
Here's why I think that it's kind of dying, though. Like, first off, the fact that Microsoft is even in the console race was kind of by accident, because they were buddy-buddy with Sega when the Dreamcast was out, and then Sega went under, so they're like, fuck, we got this whole team of guys who know how to do this shit, let's make something out of it. And Sony, you know, that develops laptops and PCs and entertainment systems and TVs and game consoles, is making less revenue than Nintendo, who just makes game consoles. Sony's going under because of their investment in the games industry. It's killing them.
Again, it's basically, it's hardware with, it's time is money, hardware is money, and then you have to try and sell it back at a reasonable price.
Which is the struggle, whereas with PCs, it's A, expected to be more expensive, and B, even, you can be entry-level and still build yourself a mean PC, and it's upgradable. And here's my real problem, why I really think it's getting phased out. The Xbone and the PS4 are just specialized PCs. They use normal PC hard drives, they use normal PC parts. Their operating system is really similar to the user interface of something on Windows or Mac. It's just, like, it's really turning into PCs. They're dumb, specialized PCs.
It also doesn't help that, as of now, they don't really have any killer apps with the exception of the PS4, which has Bloodborne.
Yeah.
Well, if we're talking about dumb, specialized PCs, the smartphone gaming market right now is super hot.
Yeah.
Well, that's because they're replacing with what consoles used to be, where you can just like slap in a disc and just have yourself a good time. Whereas with smartphone gaming, just pull out your phone and have a good time.
Konami's giving up their entire business just to get into the fucking smartphone market.
Well,
it's so stupid.
That and pachinkos.
They're both because of their decision. They are both losing money, but they are going to be making more money potentially in the long run if they can produce a game that enough people will buy. It's really
losing fans making money.
Which, when you come down to it from a business standpoint, is the point of your company.
Yeah, but
you
fucking
don't like it, but you can't
argue. They have no goodwill.
I mean, are you gonna keep chopping wood when you don't need any more wood? Or are you gonna mine the coal?
Burn down the forest?
Because you need the coal to run your trains. You can't run the coal train on wood.
Yes, you can. I mean, charcoal
train. I understand.
You actually can.
I understand your metaphor, but what the fuck are you going on about?
I think Gil
company,
just, like, went industrial.
The company needs money. They don't need more fans. They've got plenty of fans. Every company that's in the market right now has diehard fans. Even EA has diehard fans.
Fucking
that say,
Nintendo.
Oh, it's an EA game. I'm going to get that new EA game,
Shenmue.
Guys.
No, EA has diehard
I don't get
FIFA
why
fans.
They decide. Well, that's because in most of the countries, like, FIFA's the only game available.
And soccer in a lot of places that aren't America. Soccer is life. Ball is
I
literally
think you
life.
Mean football.
Yes.
We're in America.
Football,
it's soccer.
The beautiful sport.
You mean football.
Football.
We just need to bring the friendly Australian in here and he can tell us all that we're wrong.
Go!
We're not bringing
oh, that's for another episode.
To talk about football.
Back to Konami, like, in terms of them not being in the games things, like, well, at least now Kojima can actually start something new, and it'll eventually degrade into complete shenanigans.
I feel like he's going to be a little bit jaded from the last couple of years of his time at Konami, though.
Hmm. Well, in that case, like, he'll work where he's in charge, and that could either be good or bad. On one hand, he'll have unrestricted freedom. On the other hand, unrestricted freedom.
Precisely.
Yeah, he's got to generate all of the resources himself instead of Konami being like, we got you, fam. We're going to help you make some decent games.
Oh, I'm sure he'll, if he releases a Kickstarter that's Iron Cog Liquid, a Mactical Melf action game. I'm sure fans will have him covered.
He's pulling at all the straws.
He's going for it. He's reaching for that.
How about this? Just put this in your head. Yeah, right?
There you go.
We're gonna take the FromSoft office. All right, it's already starting on a good baseline. We're gonna throw in Hideo Kojima, Suda51, and Miyamoto.
Throw Platinum Games in there too, because that new Transformers IP looks hype.
I don't think Platinum Games has ever made a bad game.
Imagine Platinum Games and FromSoft working together.
Imagine
Dark Souls Revengeance.
Imagine FromSoftware and Bethesda working together.
Well,
here's my theory, though.
Dark Souls Revengeance.
As would I.
I guess I could see, like, if he wanted to, Kojima could do the same thing that Igarashi's doing, because he's got that fucking
Bloodstained Ritual of the Night, which is totally not Castlevania, by the way.
Well, it's the same thing too with the fucking, what was it, Mighty Number 9 or whatever.
It's fucking Mega Man. Everyone knows it's Mega Man, but legally it's not Mega Man.
No, it's just Mega Man.
The legal
9.
System is bullshit.
So he can just do. He can
it's
just do
Mega
that.
Man 9 is what it is. I don't remember there being a Mega Man 9.
There already is a Mega
there's
Man.
All
Man
I remember
10.
Is,
dude, there's Mega
also
Man 9
Mega
and
Man 10.
All I remember was Mega Man 8 going into Mega Man X. I don't remember there being a 9, and that's my canon, and I refuse to believe there's
a
Mega Man 9.
There was a Mega Man 9, and then there was
a
Mega
X
Man
is
X,
a different...
and then there was a Mega Man 10.
The numeral Mega Man games are a different canon from the X franchise. The X franchise is a completely different thing.
I still
want
Mega
Dr.
Man
Light's
Legend.
Dead.
Am I the only one that wants that?
Don't, Tony. You're
making everybody
me sad.
Wants that.
Okay, if we're talking about things that everybody wanted,
they were so close.
Someone explain to me the hype around The Last Guardian, because I don't know it. Someone talk to me about this.
I've never played it.
I got Last Guardian.
I think that's what Team Ico was working on for like 5 years, but it keeps on getting
played.
Well,
no, here's what happened. Okay, so it was. So you know that Shadow of the Colossus and Ico or whatever are loosely together.
Yes.
They are?
This is supposed to loosely be the third game in a loose trilogy.
That's pretty loose.
Produced by that team.
So
here's what happened, though. In, like, 2007, this game was supposed to be the killer app for the PS3. PS3, sorry. Then there was some development news that came out, and then it went fucking silent for almost a decade. No one heard anything about it, and now people are arguing that it might end up as an exclusive on the PS4, which would be horseshit because they announced it for the PS3. They have the technology to make it run on the PS3. If they don't, I'm going to be very pissed.
Then again, Sony would toss them more money
that they
way.
Would.
Yeah.
They're still selling PS3.
Everything's a business model, Christian.
They're still selling PS2.
They're still selling Xbox 360.
No, they're not, actually.
Second world country position where the main console is PS2 because... third-party support
I was.
Stuff.
By the way, is anyone else really happy that Fallout 4 is not going to be on old-gen consoles, so that way they can just focus on making a better game instead of making things ported?
Well,
I don't...
when games are, like, made for two different console generations, things can get weird. Like, look at Mercenaries 2.
You know...
made for PS2 and current... and, well, at the time, current gen.
My issue here...
that's a little
weird. My issue here with games that want to play on both consoles, I appreciate it, because I only have a PlayStation 3 and a shit-tier computer, and I'm really not planning to get a new console. I'm just going to upgrade the computer. Frankly... it's sad, but not a lot of these games are going to come to PC.
Yeah, a very small portion.
Yeah, and
but, okay.
Honestly, exclusives are shenanigans. The only reason that things can be PC exclusive is because they have limitations that can only factor in with the PC, whether it be resources, effort, or technology.
I want to be hype for a lot of these games that want to do the dual console gen...
cross-platform.
Not cross-platform. Console generation. The last generation, the current generation stuff. But just take a look at Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 5. Okay? What they're doing, from what I hear, is it's going to be on PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4, so you know both console generations. But the PlayStation 3 version's not going to have the online multiplayer. I mean, my favorite thing about the Pro Skater series, back in the day at least, was having some friends to play it with. You know, it wasn't ever about the campaign mode, because I was too young to understand what campaign mode was. It was about playing, you know, Trick Attack with the homies just sitting here. You know, it was about grabbing the neighborhood, chilling in someone's basement, playing, you know, Skate. Like, where are we at?
See who is the hypest skater.
Precisely.
And then they're going to take it, okay, I can get it, I can play the game on my PlayStation 3, you know, assuming it's not breaking like it usually is, because it has a fit about every other game, but I can't play it online, and I can't, you know, show up everyone else on the block, so to speak.
The one...
Is Tony Hawk still alive?
Yes,
or...
he is still alive.
Okay.
He's
like, what, 50?
He's pretty old, though.
Jesus.
And he's still doing stuff, or is he retired?
I think he's retired.
He's retired. It's all
yeah,
like...
I mean, he still skates, but he doesn't skate professionally.
Yeah, that hoverboard thing was cool.
I mean, it's...
Which we'll never have in our lifetime.
Yeah, the one problem is that we're going to run into the issue of... I mean, it's not going to be as bad as, like, if anyone saw the difference between the GameCube version of Twilight Princess and the Wii version of Twilight Princess and how terrifyingly better the GameCube version was. I don't think we'll run into that, but maybe, you know, because the control schemes were completely different.
Here's the...
Well, hang on, let me just
Twilight
put this
Princess
out
came
here.
Out
but
in
Christian,
yeah,
like,
I know.
There could be either two scenarios in terms of, like, different generational gaming. It could be, like, Shadow of Mordor, if I remember correctly, where it was available on both generations, but one looked better and stuff, and better frame rates and stuff. But then you have the other situation where it's like Mercenaries 2 or Splinter Cell Double Agent, where they're two completely different games.
Here's the real problem, though. The PS2 to PS3 jump isn't really a good argument, because you gained a lot from PS2 to PS3. Blu-ray, HD support, true, like, built-in online gaming. The HD support is the real thing, too. PS3 to PS4, you're just getting a faster system. You're not getting new features. You're not getting something that's fundamentally better. So I really don't think there's a lot of argument for dual-generation support to not be standard in most games. I'm not saying that you can't have purpose-built games for the PS4. In fact, I'm hoping for that, because I want there to be justification for me to buy a fucking PS4 besides two
Okay, here's a question.
Games.
Here's a question. The Xbox One is getting backwards compatibility. How are they doing that? If the system wasn't already backwards compatible, are they just patching code in that says, hey, you can read this?
It can read all base DVDs, and there's already... I have the preview program for the Xbox One backwards compatibility, and all I have to say is it works. That's basically it.
Here's what it does, though. You insert game. Game says, yo, fam, no DRM. He's got a legit copy. Xbox then downloads the game. You're not playing off of the disc. The disc is just your fucking CD key.
Yep.
That's weird.
Meaning, if it's a game that they don't have the license for, they're not allowed to modify the code, and you can't play it.
Precisely.
I wonder if there's DRM, like, if you... Do you use the disc like a play disc on old PC games?
Yes, that's precisely what you do. The disc is proof that you legitimately own the game. And here's what's really shitty. Half of the titles that are being launched in the first wave were download-only games anyways.
Yeah, pretty much.
Wait.
So that's not backwards compatibility. That's just adding games to your store from the last generation.
Mass Effect is kind of like one of the only ones that actually has like a there's a disc for it, and they also have Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts on there as well, which again there was a disc for.
Not a good game.
It wasn't a very good game. It was fun, but it wasn't a good game.
It was a bad Banjo-Kazooie game.
Yeah,
it was
exactly.
A good game.
Yeah, but the thing again, I have the preview program for it, so I know it does work. I went out and purchased a Mass Effect copy and stuck it in there, and voila, it's happening. So what I think is going, again, it's going to be that thing where it's just, they're going to patch the code for the game when you install the game, you know, to put it in there. Because they only have a certain number of games currently available for backwards compatibility on the preview program, and they're expanding the list as they go.
Well, I wouldn't know any about that. I don't think I'll have experienced it, because I'm not going to get, like, the PS4 or Xbox One, because there aren't any games released for it. The only game for the PS4 that I would be interested in is Bloodborne, and other than that, there's nothing.
Again, yeah, it's that same thing. It's
new Ratchet and Clank.
Yeah, I am hyped for the new Ratchet and Clank.
Indeed.
Which is basically, isn't it...
What it's supposed to be.
It's supposed to be the same as the movie. Isn't it the first game, but in the future?
The way that
timeline?
I understood it, it was supposed to be the movie, but the movie is supposed to be the same storyline as the first game, or something like that. It's basically a... It's basically a tweaked remake. It's the same storyline, but it's different in ways that we don't know yet.
Remastered.
New weapons.
It's not a remaster.
Yeah, there's new cutscenes, there's new enemies, stuff like that. But we just don't know what specifically.
Same story told differently.
And I'm just over here like, the one time I was going to get a PlayStation was when Toonami had the Sly Cooper PlayStation 2 giveaway.
Oh,
oh my
yeah.
God,
I missed
that
Toonami.
Was so good.
Yeah.
It is. Well, it's
still around.
It's the new
it's
one.
Just, they... It's the Adult Swim anime block now.
Yep.
Eh, it's not the same.
Bo-bo-bo-bo-bo-bo!
It is, not in the least. Bo-bo-bo-bo-bo-bo was such a fucking head trip that I couldn't even handle it when I was a kid. I was just like...
That was my shit when I was younger. I was just like...
I have no idea what's going on.
Why was there an entire episode revolving around him finding a jacket?
The better question is, why does he fight with his nose hairs?
I don't remember.
The better question is, why
yeah,
does anything...
Why does that exist? That's like...
That the better question is, what was that studio on?
You know, I'm pretty sure they just, like,
the
accidentally opened a canister in ether and were like, we're going to make a TV show.
Okay. Okay, yeah, let's get back on a topic that we're actually supposed to be talking about. What was our last official topic? Okay, let's go back. Let's just go back to games. What was the coolest thing you guys saw at E3?
Just Cause 3.
Just Cause 3.
Fallout 4. Just end of story.
Fallout 4?
Probably Fallout 4, but I'm intrigued by the prospect of Gears 4. I just know that it's going to be an Xbox exclusive, and I'm going to have to fucking buy an Xbox just so I can play the next game.
Well, I honestly don't know where they could go from there. Like, just Gears of War 3. Oh, wait, spoilers for Gears of War 3, in case anyone cares, despite the fact that it released, like, what, a...
Marcus's dad!
You don't get a... People don't get a fucking spoiler warning if the game's been out for that long, just tell
people
it.
Complain to me about
no
spoiling
one cares.
Final Fantasy
Shush,
7.
Go!
Anyway, fucking Gears 3, it. Pretty much all the locusts are dead, and it's just ended with, like, well, there are some humans left.
Yeah, that's the
yay.
Thing on, In Gears 4, in the trailer that we saw, I forget his name, I forget the character's name. We see them fighting something that, we
new
see them
characters.
Fighting something that aren't
that
locusts.
Aren't locusts.
It's a new enemy, basically, is what we're
it's
seeing.
Some sort of, it was some sort of, like,
it was a weird,
monster
like, monster creature
thing.
Thing.
Some weird
thing.
Monkey dog thing, sir.
Oh, Carmine, you got shot in the head.
No, you know what? Aside from Unravel, because Yarny is the hypest thing since sliced bread, that one, I don't remember what the title was for the IP, but the one with the chick main character fighting robot dinosaurs. Anyone remember that one?
Yeah, that's called Recore.
I remember that.
I really
no,
wanted...
That's wait, not Recore. Recore is the one that has the chick with the robot dog.
Yes.
This one was during the Sony conference, I believe. It was a brand new IP.
I didn't watch the Sony conference.
It was this one chick that basically what had happened was the storyline was for some reason humanity went back to tribal living. You know, everyone went back to being non-tech.
Scalping people.
Basically. And, you know, the whole sense that we were getting was, you know, I think it showed like either it was New York or Chicago or some city. It showed some city all burnt out, you know, you had the skyscrapers all up in ruins and being overgrown and stuff like that. And the whole sense of the idea was everything, it was like nature took back over and then humanity went back to tribe. And then, you know, the chick was out and she was about to hunt something. And then suddenly you realize everything is dinosaurs, but they're not just dinosaurs, they're robot dinosaurs.
So basically what you're saying is the Viking Age from Kung Fury.
Yes.
Excellent.
Yes.
Clearly that's what this is.
The laser rafters, man.
They're robot dinosaurs, so there better be lasers.
I just imagine Sony. Producing their own movie.
And girls
here
with miniguns and big tits.
It's called Horizon Zero Dawn.
Now that is a stupid title.
The title is doesn't tell you anything, but they showed some gameplay, and this
is
hype.
Why is one of the dumbest titles
I've
ever heard?
It literally sounds like a military operation.
Metal Gear Rising Revengeance.
Revengeance is in fact a word. I looked it up.
I'm gonna throw you guys this Kotaku article real quick so that you can look at it.
Save it for the show notes.
Don't
forget.
Of course.
And I guess while we're on the topic of robots and shit, let's talk about ReCore.
Yeah.
I don't know what ReCore is.
I only watched the Bethesda conference.
ReCore is the,
I fell asleep.
ReCore is the new Microsoft IP that's coming out. They only showed the cinematic trailer, so I can't really, you know,
say much about gameplay.
It looks interesting, to say the least.
What happened during the cinematic was it was another female protagonist. There was a lot of female protagonists this year.
Anyone can be a protagonist.
Yeah, precisely.
But what it did...
In which we need a game where we more or less play as Senator Armstrong. I'm just throwing that out there.
Wasn't that the Incredible Hulk Ultimate Destruction?
What about Saints Row 4?
Yeah,
that works too.
Crap, Tony's actually on to something.
No, but anyway, the ReCore trailer, I don't really understand what was going on. I just know that there was this chick, and she looked like she was up in, like, I don't know, Australia, except it was winter, because there was a whole bunch of crazy things that were trying to kill her, except they were robots. So, you know, crazy things trying to kill you, that's Australia.
Yeah. I think what it kind of looked like...
Killer Australian robot.
It kind of looked like the Sahara
Except
Desert.
Except everything was covered in snow,
just
too, I think.
The outback.
At one point, everything was snow, and then she was in a desert. So I don't really know what was going on.
No, it wasn't snow. It was always sand. She got hit by a dust storm. That's what it was, yeah.
Ah. Okay.
Yeah. No, it looked like she was in the Sahara Desert.
Yeah, you'd know about that of all
people. Yeah, Wulf lives in the desert. But
dude,
what happened when she got
fun
attacked?
Sand skiing is.
We'll get back to that before we end.
Right. Oh, something.
She got attacked, and then her little robot dog got killed, and everyone was like, "Oh my god, no! The dog got killed!" And then she pulled its power core out and put it in a bigger dog suit that just happened to be there, it came back to life.
The bigger dog suit literally,
backup dog.
It literally looked like a bigger version. It literally looked like a smaller version of Dog from the Half-Life 2 series.
It does.
And I'm just over here thinking to myself, like, Half-Life 3. No. No.
But go on.
What if that's just how Alex looks now? That'd be kind of funny.
Damn it. And there's also the part that there can't be Half-Life 3. It has to be Half-Life 2 Episode 3 because the Half-Life 2 story isn't over.
Nerd!
And it will never be finished, Christian.
Shut the fuck up, Chandler. Let me dream.
No, there's going to be Half-Life Episode 2.5.
I will fucking murder somebody.
No, it'll be 2.3 and it'll be half as long as 2.5.
No, 2.15 just to piss people off even more.
Okay. So, we're in the last 5 minutes, so let's talk about this sand skiing nonsense, Wulf. Well, what are you going on about there?
Sand skiing? It's a thing.
Wait, hang on. I just want to say this. I don't want to remake a Final Fantasy 7. I do want to remake a Final Fantasy 6, though.
Okay.
In the style of Final Fantasy 4 remake, like a touch of...
I kind
of
thought...
Dust up sprites and translations.
I kind of thought that...
I agree. And all Final Fantasy games need more super bosses.
Nope.
I kind of thought that Final Fantasy XIV was a remake of Final Fantasy VII, but that's because I don't play the Final Fantasy games.
Honestly, none of them have any correlation to each other at all.
You
want
to know what correlation they have to each other? A character by the name of Sid
trains?
Who fixes things.
Yep. And sometimes is a girl.
And occasionally Espers and Magitek.
Yeah.
Because those are words that get used every now and then.
Oh, yeah. Wait, what are the games with that mention besides Final Fantasy VI?
They weren't called Espers, but all the summons are Espers.
Yeah.
Oh.
So literally, the only thing those games have in common are the summons, the weapons, and Sid.
What,
Sid
what
is
Final
the
Fantasy
great
X and
equalizer.
X2 have all the same characters?
No, they don't. Payne's a new character.
Yes.
Who?
Ta-da! No, no. Here's what you're missing. Payne is just a female version of Squall. No,
isn't
seriously,
no way,
think
don't...
about it.
Nah.
The protagonist of Final Fantasy VIII. Hold on, I gotta pull this up.
We'll throw
this. Is that
this
the
up.
Guy who was the whole shooting and stabbing?
He's the guy from Final Fantasy VIII with the gunblade. So yes.
All right.
The fucking gunblade. Oh man.
You can't fuck with a gunblade. I'm sorry.
I feel that the show Ruby from Rooster Teeth is just hey gunblades, and that's the entire show.
My gunblade.
That's it. That's the whole.
Gary.
Show.
Okay.
One. And two.
Oh, okay. There.
These need to be
I never played Final Fantasy X2. I'm going to safely assume it was either that was a decent game, or, okay,
wait
things got weird really freaking fast. Or
it was
it
a disasterific game.
They really are the same
person. If you have played the game, you'd get the joke. It's literally a word used in the game, and it's fucking terrible. That game's good for all the wrong reasons.
It's
kind of like Disaster Day of Crisis.
Final Fantasy X2 is Let's Play Dress Up the Shooter. To be honest.
I thought that was Final Fantasy 13-3.
They say lightning never strikes twice in the same location, but lightning clearly struck three times in a row.
Lightning returned too many times.
Lightning, I don't understand.
It was bad the first time.
Yeah.
Then he decided to make a second one.
Why?
And then they decided to make a third one that
Square Enix
no
really
one
likes
wanted.
Lightning. I mean, okay, what games was she in? She was in Dissidia, Final Fantasy. She had three of her own games. There was a costume for her in Parasite Eve 3, which I'm not fucking calling Third Birthday because that's what it is. What other games was she in? Anyone have any ideas?
I have no clue.
Honestly, I don't get why the whole popularity was things like, okay, we're going to employ the Qui-Gon Jinn test. Like, describe Lightning without describing her appearance or what she does.
She stabs things with the gun blade.
That's all.
No, that's what she does. You have to describe her personality.
A plate.
She brews.
A plate. That is it.
She broods and gets angry at people.
And then she motivates them. Just do it!
Do it!
That's Shia LaBeouf.
That is Lightning. Shia LaBeouf is Lightning.
Oh, God.
Yes.
Oh, God,
are
no.
you on Ether, Gil?
I'm always
on
Ether.
I don't want to imagine.
Could you just imagine
okay,
Shia LaBeouf
so
in that
other
outfit?
Than Shia LaBeouf and a plate, do you have anything else?
No.
A canvas.
Exactly.
A blank
Lightning
canvas.
Lightning is a stupid character.
She has no character.
Yeah.
But you know who did have character was the black guy in that game? I forgot his name. I think it was something with an S. Saz. Saz sounds about right.
Honestly, in terms of games, like, even if the stories and characters are just, like, bad, the gameplay can see it. See Middle-Earth, Shadow of Mordor. Game of the
Correct.
Year for a lot of people. I have no idea what the main characters' names are. I've played it for 32 hours.
Why do you not know the main characters' names? Are they not said?
It's not
because
important.
Because they're completely forgettable.
What's important is killing
art. Okay, well, that...
Gameplay was fantastic. I recommend the game to all of you. I can't remember the main character's names.
All I remembered about that game and its story is that my character was out to get his revengeance, and then I immediately played the game like Metal Gear Rising.
I don't know.
I think that's a good point to end this first podcast on.
Sand skiing!
Anyone else you guys want to say before we stop this?
Dune buggies are awesome.
Donald Trump is an incompetent jackhole.
All right.
Donald Trump, 2015.
Ron Paul, 2016.
Keep the dream alive.
That's even better. 16.
Keep the dream alive.
Ron Paul, 2016.
Isn't he
dead?
No,
he's still alive.
Rand Paul.
Is he?
Rand Paul, 2016.
Anyway. Rand Paul, I don't like as much. He doesn't have the charisma.
The question is Rand Paul going to be an extension of Ron Paul?
That's because he isn't an idiot.
Quite.
Okay.
What about Vern's dream?
Before this turns bad, let's just stop here.
Goodbye, internet friends.
All right, and stop.
Stop.